They say this is just the start of it. Welcome to summer. It's going to be a wet one.
So over 50 of our gauges saw over 100 millimetres in the past 24 hours in the southeast of Queensland alone.
And it was intense. Overnight, flash flooding took many by surprise. At Toombul, Kedron Creek burst its banks. Unbelievable to think some people thought they could drive through this. This driver wouldn't have made it out without the help of emergency services. Sam lives close by and he was preparing to evacuate.
It was a bit scary for us as well because, you know, in the night time when the creeks get flooded and just living nearby in this area, so it's really scary.
On the scenic rim today, a miracle that a motorist escaped from this. He was found clinging to the car, desperately waiting for rescue crews to save him.
That's scary. That is really, really scary. Like, you couldn't take anything through that.
More than 40 roads across the state are closed, but some drivers didn't care. This driver swerved past road closed signs at Alberta near Billawheeler, tried to navigate through 2 metres of fast-flowing water, but was swept away and later hit with a hefty fine.
It's inexcusable that people continue to drive into floodwaters, putting not only themselves but first responders' lives at risk.
West of Brisbane at Yalanga, a car has been swept off the road too. While closer to the city, 6 hours of heavy rain was too much for Adrian Fletcher's house in Paddington. Wading in ankle-deep stormwater isn't how he wanted to celebrate finishing years of hard work.
I'm pretty annoyed. 2 days ago, and I was literally just threw away my last paintbrush, just finished the renovations for inside. I think I'm still in shock.
Today was spent surveying the damage and counting the cost.
While the rain has eased up somewhat today, we're not out of the woods just yet. Showers and storms are expected over the next 5 days, and because the ground is already saturated, it won't take much for the water to rise again.
We have several months to go through this, and we're not even in cyclone season yet, so we really need everyone to be listening to the message.
While a number of rivers in the southeast, including the Bremer at Ipswich and the Logan at Albert, are on major flood watch. Amanda Hart for 10 News First.
Let's go to our own weather expert, Josh Holt. Josh, what's on the radar for this flood emergency tonight and into tomorrow?
Well, Sandra, the radar today really clicked into overdrive. And as we've just heard, that is really the scary thought out of this whole process, that the monsoon hasn't actually even set in yet and the tropical cyclones haven't even begun to spun up. And as you can see here, we've got plenty of cloud cover across areas of southeast Queensland. That catchment is absolutely saturated at this current point in time. And you can understand why by looking at the southeast radar today. We saw steady rain overnight, but then we had a line of heavy showers and thunderstorms that developed very close to the southeast coast, and as a result we saw huge amounts of rain into the gauges in quite a short period of time. Palmview on the Sunshine Coast, 118 millimetres. This is since 9 o'clock this morning. Banksia Beach out on Bribie, 114 millimetres. Hendra 56 and Redland 46 into the gauge since 9 o'clock this morning. We've got major flood warnings in place across a large portion of Queensland at the moment. We'll have a deeper look at this and what we can expect over the next couple of days.